So what is spermatogenesis? Spermatogenesis is the process of formation of sperms. So here, before we are going into the process of spermatogenesis, you should remember few points we learned in male reproductive system. First point is, each testis consists of highly coiled testicular tubules or seminiferous tubules, which form 80% of the testicular substance, are the sites for sperm production. So which is the site for sperm production? Seminiferous tubules. Next point, seminiferous tubule is made up of two types of cells. What are the two types of cells? Sertoli cells and spermatogonic cells. Two types of cells, Sertoli cells and spermatogonic cells. What is the function of Sertoli cells? It provide nourishment to the sperms till maturation. Sertoli cells provide nourishment to the sperms till maturation. Spermatogonic cells divide meiotically and differentiate to produce spermatozoa. So, seminiferous tubule is made up of two types of cells. They are Sertoli cells and spermatogonic cells. Sertoli cells provide nourishment to the developing sperms and spermatogonic cells divide meiotically and differentiate to produce spermatozoa. Now we are going to learn about the sequence of events in spermatogenesis. So spermatogenesis is the sequence of events in the seminiferous tubules of the testes that produce the male gametes, sperms. Now you know the synthesis or the formation of sperms takes place in the seminiferous tubules of the testes that produce the male gametes, sperms. During development, the primordial germ cells migrate into the testes and become immature germ cells called sperm mother cells or spermatogonia in the inner surface of the seminiferous tubules. So, how the sperm mother cells or spermatogonia is formed? During development, the primordial germ cells migrate into the testes and become immature germ cells called the sperm mother cells or the spermatogonia in the inner surfaces of the seminiferous tubules. The spermatogonia begin to undergo mitotic division at puberty and continue throughout the life. So, the spermatogonia begin to undergo mitotic division at puberty. Once the organism attain sexual maturity, the spermatogonia begin to undergo mitotic division and it continue throughout the life of the organism. It continue throughout the life of the organism. In the first stage of spermatogenesis, the spermatogonia migrate along with the Sertoli cells towards the central lumen of the seminiferous tubule and become modified and enlarged to form primary spermatocytes, which are deployed with 23 pairs of chromosome. How many pairs of chromosome? 23 pairs of chromosome, that is totally 46 chromosomes. So here first is the formation of sperm mother cells or spermatogonia. Then in the first stage of spermatogenesis, the spermatogonia migrate along with the Sertoli cells towards the central lumen of the seminiferous tubule and become modified and enlarged to form primary spermatocytes, which are deployed with 23 pairs of chromosomes. Some of the primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division to form two secondary spermatocytes, which are haploid with 23 chromosomes each. So, you know, first the primary spermatocytes are formed, which is deployed with 23 pairs of chromosome. Some of the primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division, that is the reduction division, to form two secondary spermatocytes which are haploid with 23 chromosomes each. Again, the secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division to produce 4 haploid spermatids. The secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division to produce 4 haploid spermatids. So you should remember the sequence: primary spermatocytes, which is diploid in number, which undergo first meiotic division to form the secondary spermatocytes. Secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division to form the spermatids. The spermatids are transformed into mature spermatozoa or sperms by the process called spermiogenesis. Again, the spermatids transformed into mature spermatozoa or sperms by the process called spermiogenesis. Sperms are finally released into the cavity of seminiferous tubules by a process called spermiation. So what is spermiation? Sperms are finally released into the cavity of seminiferous tubules by a process called spermiation. The whole process of spermatogenesis takes about 64 days. The whole process of spermatogenesis takes about 64 days. At any given time, different regions of the seminiferous tubules contain spermatocytes in different stages of development. So you know the primary spermatocytes undergo different stages and finally it forms the sperms or the spermatozoa. So in the different regions of the seminiferous tubules, which contain spermatocytes in different stages of development, maybe the primary spermatocytes or the secondary spermatocytes or the spermatids. Okay, the sperm production remains nearly constant at a rate of about 200 million sperms per day. So the total production of sperms per day is 200 million. So what are the events takes place in the spermatogenesis? In the first stage of spermatogenesis, the spermatogonia migrate along with the Sertoli cells towards the central lumen of the seminiferous tubule and become modified and enlarged to form primary spermatocytes, which is diploid in nature, that is 23 pairs of chromosome present. Then the primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division to form the secondary spermatocytes. Secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division to form the spermatids. Again, the spermatids are transformed into mature spermatozoa by the process called spermiogenesis, that is the formation of sperms. Again, the sperms are finally released into the cavity of seminiferous tubules by a process called spermiation. The whole process takes place about 64 days. The whole process of spermatogenesis takes about 64 days. At any given time, different regions of the seminiferous tubule contain spermatocytes in different stages of development. The sperm production remains nearly constant at a rate of about 200 million sperms per day. Next, you should remember the term we learnt already. Some hormones also involved in the process of spermatogenesis. That is, the spermatogenesis starts at the age of puberty and is initiated due to the increase in the release of gonadotropin-releasing hormone by the hypothalamus. So, the spermatogenesis starts at the age of puberty. How it is initiated? It is initiated due to the increase of some hormone. What is the hormone name? Gonadotropin-releasing hormone by the hypothalamus. Again, the gonadotropin releasing hormone acts on the anterior pituitary gland and stimulates the secretion of 2 gonadotropins. So, from the hypothalamus, gonadotropin releasing hormone is released, which will stimulate the anterior pituitary gland to release 2 gonadotropin. What are the 2 gonadotropins? follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. Follicle stimulates follicular stimulating hormone or FSH stimulates testicular growth and enhances the production of androgen binding protein by the Sertoli cells and helps in the process of spermiogenesis. So, follicular stimulating hormone or FSH stimulates testicular growth and enhances the production of androgen binding protein by the Sertoli cells and helps in the process of spermiogenesis. Second hormone, luteinizing hormone, acts on the Leydig cells and stimulates the synthesis of testosterone, which in turn stimulates the process of spermatogenesis. Luteinizing hormone acts on the Leydig cells and stimulates the synthesis of testosterone, which in turn stimulates the process of spermatogenesis. So here the spermatogenesis starts at the age of puberty and it is initiated by the increase in some hormone. What is the hormone name here? Gonadotropin releasing hormone by the hypothalamus. This gonadotropin releasing hormone acts on the anterior pituitary gland and stimulates the secretion of two gonadotropins. What are the two gonadotropins? Follicle stimulating hormone or FSH and luteinizing hormone. This follicle stimulating hormone stimulates the testicular growth and enhances the production of androgen binding protein by the Sertoli cells and helps in the process of spermiogenesis. Luteinizing hormone acts on the Leydig cells and stimulates the synthesis of testosterone, which in turn stimulates the process of spermatogenesis.